Photoshop menu is for Mac only. It is used to adjust Photoshop preferences. You can click on General and access other preferences in the submenu. Hide Photoshop program or quit it entirely. Windows users will find these commands either in the File or Edit menus. The File menu allows you to create a new document, open an existing document, open recent documents, close the document, save the document, or save document as, where you can choose a different name and the file format, like popular JPEGs or GIFs used for clip art, TIFF files or native Photoshop files. You can also import documents from the different input devices, like your scanner. If you have a scanner attached to your computer, the name of your scanner will show up in the submenu. Then you can set up your page to print, select the printer, page orientation, and paper size, and finally print, where you can access also page setup, orientation, select your printer and printer options. Click done if you simply want to assign the settings to the document, or click print. The edit menu allows you to apply basic editing commands to selected object and edit document presets. Use edit to undo or redo your actions, as well as cut, copy, paste, and clear. Keep in mind, just like in any other software, before you can use cut, copy, and clear, you need to select what you actually want to copy, paste, and clear. In Photoshop, you'll be using Selections tool to do so. Copy. Clear and paste. If you have a text in your document, you can check the spelling or find and replace text. Like so. The fill command in edit menu allows you to fill your document or selection with color, or pattern. By default, Photoshop gives you a number of presets, but you can also create your custom pattern, which I will show you how to do later in this session. And with the stroke command, you can outline your image. Or selection. Some other important features in edit menu are transform commands. Use free transform to reduce, enlarge, rotate your image or selection. You can hold shift key to scale proportionally. You can also use option bar to set specific values, like angle degree or percentage value of the size of the image. If you will activate this icon, it will allow you to scale your image, maintaining aspect ratio. When you are ready to exit Free Transform feature, just click on any tool and choose to apply if you are happy with the changes that you've made. Cancel to go back, continue changing, or don't apply to go back to your original image. Transform command also allows you to scale and rotate, as well as skew, distort, and warp your image and selection. In addition, it has a number of rotation and flip presets. The next set of commands in Edit menu is about defining your own brushes and patterns. To define the entire image as pattern, simply choose Define Pattern. Preview it and name it in the pop-up window. Click OK or Cancel. To define specific area of your image as pattern, select Rectangular Marquee Selection tool from the tool palette. Click and drag around the area that you want to define. Go back to Edit menu. Choose Define Pattern. Preview. Name it. And select OK. You can find your newly created pattern in the Fill menu. Choose Pattern. Click on Custom Pattern Thumb. Scroll all the way down. Click on the thumb to select, and click OK. To delete your pattern, simply go back to Fill, right-click on the thumb, and click Delete Pattern, and click OK. The rest of the Edit menu is about your document and Photoshop presets, where you can purge your undos and histories, set color profile to your document, or set your personal shortcuts. The Image menu allows you to manipulate the size and the appearance of your document. Use the Image menu to set the color mode, make adjustments to image coloring, duplicate your document, change image size and resolution, change canvas size, rotate the canvas, and finally crop your document. The Mode command allows you to select the desired color mode for your document. You don't need to remember them all. Our recommended settings are RGB color and 8-bit channel. In fact, I encourage you, whenever you open a document or create a new one, to make sure that your mode is set to RGB and 8-bit channel. The Adjustment submenu offers a variety of commands that allow you to recolor or modify the colors of your artwork. Some of the more commonly used adjustment commands include Brightness, Contrast, Hue Saturation, Desaturate, if you want your image to be in grayscale. Replace color. Invert. Threshold, that converts your image into black and white. The higher the level, the more black it's going to pick. And finally, variations. Variations allow you to change overall color balance in your image. For example, I want to add more yellow to my midtones. Make shadows slightly darker. And highlights lighter. We encourage you to experiment with these features on your own.